dismantle the quantum drive until the technology can be perfected. Despite the setback, we have a renewed sense of momentum. It no longer seems a question of if we get home, but when. Eddie, am I interrupting?
No. I just came here to try to figure things out.
Phase corrections.
The corrections I sent you were wrong. If you had used them, Voyager would have been heavily damaged, maybe even destroyed. What I can't figure out is who sent the other phase corrections to 7 of 9.
Looks like we've got a guardian angel.
Oh, I wish I could believe that.
Believe it. His name is Harry Kim.
Captain?
7 found a Starfleet security code embedded in the transmission. Yours?
I'm telling you, I didn't send it.
Not yet. The transmission had a temporal displacement. We believe it originated from the future. 10, 20 years from now, we can't be sure.
Wait a second. If I sent a message from the future and changed the past, then that future would no longer exist, right? So, how could I have sent the message in the first place? Am I making any sense?
My advice in making sense of temporal paradoxes is simple. Don't even try. To me, all that matters is that somewhere, somehow, sometime, you come through for us. Well, if you won't take it from me, take it from you. 7 found a log entry encoded in the telemetry. From Harry Kim to Harry Kim.
Time, so listen to me. 15 years ago, I made a mistake, and 150 people died. I've spent every day since then regretting that mistake. But if you're watching this right now, that means all of that's changed. You owe me one.
Mr. Kim, your assistance, please.